So in the past a lot I used the 1-inch and 2-inch foam for doing these, the shadows and the highlights. You've seen them over and over in videos, but I'm always trying something new. So I've got the MAC 162 brush here. I think this is the 1-inch, and I'm going to use this to do some of the shadows here and come back with the highlights too, because I think with this I have a little more control than the foam brush. The foam brush is great for big, quick stuff. This is pretty big, but still I want to try this out. So it's not like I'm going to stop doing highlights and shadows with the 1- and 2-inch foam brushes anymore. It's just I wanted something a little bit more thick and thin, and gives me a little bit more control over that. So that's why I'm using this MAC 162 1-inch brush. So with the MAC 162, you can see I can get these finer edges and kind of nicer thick and thin on the shadows. Watching. I hope you enjoyed that little video about using the MAC 162 brush for doing highlights and shadows. But like I said before, I still use the 1-inch and 2-inch foam brushes too. It just depends on the circumstance and how much time I want to spend on the character. All right, see you next time. Thanks for watching.